Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. So in this series, now we will discuss the disaccharide part of biomolecules chemistry. So let's see disaccharides. You have already read that disaccharides on hydrolysis with dilute acids or enzymes yields two molecules of either the same or different monosaccharides. And we have discussed two examples. One is sucrose and another is nothing but example of maltose, which gives two similar molecules of glucose. So the two monosaccharides are joined together by an oxide linkage formed by the loss of water molecule. Such a linkage between two monosaccharide units through oxygen atom is called glycosidic linkage. What is glycosidic linkage? The two monosaccharides are joined together by a oxide linkage formed by the loss of a water molecule. Such a linkage between two monosaccharide units through oxygen atom is called glycosidic linkage. So within the disaccharide, what happens? The two monosaccharides are joined by an oxide linkage and it is formed by the loss of water molecule. Such a linkage between two monosaccharide units through oxygen atom is called glycosidic linkage. Between two monosaccharide units there is a oxygen. That's why when we do hydrolysis we'll get monosaccharides. In disaccharides, if the reducing group of monosaccharides, that is aldehyde group or ketonic group, are bonded, they are non-reducing sugars. Example, sucrose. On the other hand, sugars in which these functional groups are free are called reducing sugars. For example, maltose and lactose. What are reducing and non-reducing sugars? We know that the two monosaccharides are linked by a glycosidic, by an oxide linkage, that is by oxygen atom between the two monosaccharides. In disaccharides, if the reducing group of monosaccharides, reducing group means aldehyde or ketone, are bonded, these are non-reducing sugars. Example, sucrose. On other hand, sugars in which these functional groups are free are called reducing sugars. For example, maltose and lactose are reducing sugars. Sucrose is not reducing because the reducing groups of the aldehydic or ketonic groups of monosaccharide are bonded. That's why these are non-reducing sugars. On the other hand, sugars in which these functional groups are free are called reducing sugars. For example, maltose and lactose. Now let's talk about sucrose. Sucrose is one of the common disaccharides. One of the common disaccharides is sucrose, which on hydrolysis gives equimolar mixture of capital D plus the glucose, dextroglucose, and capital D levofructose minus fructose. Glucose, you will get dextro, both are dextro, but glucose is, both are capital D form, capital D. And the capital D notation gives the configuration. If the OH group is at the right side, then it is called capital D. And this we see from the bottommost asymmetrical or chiral carbon. Okay, capital D. Both are capital D, glucose and fructose capital D, but glucose is dextro and fructose is levo. Okay, C12H22O11 is the chemical formula of glucose plus water, that is hydrolysis. You will get D plus glucose and D minus fructose. These two monosaccharides are held together by a glycosidic linkage between C1 of alpha glucose and C2 of beta glucose. These two monosaccharides are held together by a glycosidic linkage. These two monosaccharides are held together by a glycosidic linkage between C1 of alpha D glucose and C2 of beta D glucose. Alpha D glucose ka C1 and beta D glucose second carbon. Since the reducing group of glucose and fructose are involved in glycosidic bond formation, sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. So you have seen that at first carbon of glucose, CHO aldehyde group is present, and at the second carbon, ketonic group is present. So, since the reducing groups of glucose and fructose are involved in glycosidic bond link formation, sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. Sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. These two monosaccharides are held together by a glycosidic bond linkage, C1 of alpha D glucose and C2 of beta D glucose. Since the reducing groups of glucose and fructose are involved in glycosidic bond formation, sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. So you can see that sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. Because C1 of alpha D glucose and C2 of beta D fructose are involved, since the aldehyde and ketonic groups are involved in bonding, the aldehydic or ketonic groups, they are not free, so they cannot give the ready, they cannot form, they cannot do reducing test. Okay, since the reducing groups of glucose and fructose are involved in glycosidic bond formation, sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. The reducing groups of glucose and fructose are involved in glycosidic bond formation, sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. Since the reducing groups of glucose and fructose are involved in glycosidic bond formation, sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. Since the reducing groups of glucose and fructose are involved, since the reducing groups of glucose and fructose are involved in glycosidic bond formation, sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. Okay, so alpha D glucose and beta D glucose are there. They are formed by glycosidic linkage. So, Benedict's tolerance failing, then non-reducing sugar, mutual rotation. This is a non-reducing sugar. Sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. Sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. Sucrose is a non-reducing sugar because C1 of alpha D glucose and C2 of beta D glucose, they are involved in bonding. As they are not free, they cannot give the reducing test. Since the reducing groups of glucose and fructose are involved in glycosidic bond formation, sucrose is a non-reducing group, non-reducing sugar. It does not give Benedict's, tolerance, failing. So does not give all these reducing tests, so it's a non-reducing sugar. Do not give mutation. Sucrose is a dextrorotatory, but after hydrolysis gives dextrorotatory glucose and levorotatory fructose. Sucrose is a dextrorotatory. What is sucrose? It is dextrorotatory, but after hydrolysis gives sucrose is dextrorotatory, but after hydrolysis it gives dextrorotatory glucose, levorotatory fructose. Since the levorotation of fructose is -92.4 degrees is more than dextrorotation of glucose +52.5 degrees, the mixture is levorotatory. It is not a racemic because levorotatory is greater than dextrorotatory, so the net is levorotatory, so the mixture is levorotatory. But before hydrolysis, sucrose is a dextrorotatory, but after hydrolysis, dextrorotatory glucose and levorotatory fructose is there. So since the levorotation of fructose is -92.4 degrees, it is more than dextrorotation of glucose, that is +52.5, the mixture is levorotatory. Thus hydrolysis of sucrose brings about a change in the sign of rotation. Hydrolysis of sucrose brings a change in the sign of rotation from dextro positive to levo minus, and the product is named as invert sugar. That's why sucrose is named as invert sugar. Thus hydrolysis of sucrose brings about a change in the sign of rotation from dextro plus to levo minus, and the product is named as invert sugar. That's why sucrose is named as invert sugar, because after hydrolysis the sign of rotation from dextro plus to changes to levo minus, and the product is named as invert sugar. Maltose. Another disaccharide maltose is composed of two alpha D glucose units, in which C1 of one glucose is linked to C4 of another glucose. Another disaccharide maltose is composed of two alpha D glucose units, in which C1 of one glucose is linked to C4 of another glucose unit. The free aldehyde group can be produced at C1 of second glucose in solution, and it shows reducing properties, so it is a reducing sugar. So this second glucose unit ka first carbon, the free aldehyde group can be produced at C1 of second glucose in solution, and it shows reducing properties, so it is a reducing sugar. Maltose is a reducing sugar because C1 of second glucose in solution, it shows reducing properties, so it is a reducing sugar. So first carbon and fourth carbon, maltose, first and second in sucrose. Now let's talk about both are alpha in maltose. Both are glucose, both are alpha glucose. I'm talking about lactose. Lactose is more commonly known as milk sugar. Since this saccharide is found in milk, lactose is milk sugar. Since this disaccharide is found in milk, it is composed of beta G galactose and beta G glucose. Both are beta G galactose and beta G glucose. The linkage is between C1 of galactose and C4 of glucose. 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 Free aldehyde groups. The linkage is between C1 of galactose and C4 of glucose. And the maltose, we were having C1 of glucose and C4 of glucose. Here C1 of galactose and C4 of glucose. Here the second sugar, C4 carbon. There also second sugar, C4 carbon. Free aldehyde group may be produced at C1 of glucose unit. Free aldehyde group may be produced at C1 of glucose. Free aldehyde group may be produced at C1 of glucose unit. Hence, it is also a reducing sugar. So, it is also a reducing sugar. And lactose is having galactose, alpha, beta galactose and beta glucose. C1 of galactose and C4 of glucose are involved in linkage. And since C1 of glucose is free, it can reduce, so it is a reducing sugar. It can be reduced, so it is a reducing sugar. Coming to maltose and sucrose is having alpha glucose and beta fructose, C1 of glucose and C2 of fructose, so it is not a reducing sugar since the aldehydic and ketonic groups are involved in bonding, glycosidic bonding. So bond between two sugars is glycosidic bond. The dextro before hydrolysis it is dextro rotatory, but after hydrolysis the net is levo rotatory, so it is called invert sugar. Maltose is another disaccharide. Maltose is composed of alpha D glucose units of C1 of one glucose linked to C4 of another glucose. The free aldehyde group can be produced as C1 of second glucose. So maltose consists of both alpha D glucose and C1 of one glucose and C4 of another glucose is involved in glycosidic bond formation. So C1 of second glucose can involved in can show reducing properties, so it is also a reducing sugar. So we conclude that sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. It is having alpha glucose and beta fructose, C1 of glucose and C2 of fructose. And maltose is a reducing sugar. It is having both alpha D glucose, two units of alpha D glucose, C1 of one glucose and C4 of another glucose is involved in linkage. Lactose is also a reducing sugar. It is having beta D galactose and alpha D glucose, beta D galactose C1 carbon and beta D glucose C4 carbon is involved in linkage. Both are beta, okay, and so it is also reducing sugar. Non-reducing sugar is sucrose. It is a previous year question in NEET, so remember this. So these all are very important, and I have covered up to disaccharides, and next we'll cover polysaccharides, and then importance of carbohydrates, and then we'll come to proteins. Thank you so much. Please consider subscribing our channel.